Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Benjamin Penny. I have the honour to be the Deputy Director of the Australian Centre on China and the World, which is hosting this film screening and the conference Taiwan, the View from the South, with which it is associated. It's wonderful to see our auditorium so full, and they say there is no audience for art forms. This is truly gratifying. It's a wonderful thing, I think, that we're doing here this evening. Tsai Ming-Lang is one of the most extraordinary film directors, not just from Taiwan, but just one of the most extraordinary filmmakers working today. We are showing his latest film. I believe it has had one, possibly two screenings in this country before at the Melbourne International Film Festival this year. I believe this is the only other screening that it's had. I had the privilege of seeing it in Taipei a couple of months ago, and I know that you will find it a really rewarding experience. So I'm going to hand over now to Linda Jaivin, who will be interviewing Director Tsai for 15 or so minutes. We will then show the film. After the screening, there will be approximately half an hour of questions and answers to Director Tsai. Just for those of you who don't know Linda Jaivin, Linda is a polymath, a literary figure, the author of 11 books, seven of which are novels, a person who has been a journalist in China, who has been engaged with Chinese literature, film, culture, politics for some years now, and has had a career which has involved Chinese cinema, cinema in Chinese from both sides of the Straits and elsewhere, as a critic, as a subtitler, as in all capacities. So I think it's wonderful and very suitable that Linda should be the person who is interviewing Director Tsai tonight. I'll hand over now, and all the best.
Thank you all very, very much for coming. It's a great honor to have Tsai Ming-Lang here with us today. And what we're going to do is, I'm going to be talking to him in Chinese, and then I'm going to translate. I'm going to translate my questions, and then I'll give you a brief translation of his answers. What we're going to do is we're going to have a little conversation beforehand, just to set some things up for those of you who are, so that you can think about when you're watching this film. And for those of you who are not totally familiar with his films, we'll just introduce a few of the themes. 就先问一下哈，关于那个哦，the first question I have is about sense of place and how that applies to this film. 您拍电影的时候呢，也说过地方就选的场地，近地也可以算一个人物。这个电影呢，它的近地感我觉得很强。而且我看了您接受的采访说选。 选地、选场地，可能有很多很多时间。能不能谈一下今天晚上我们要看的郊游的一些景点？为什么选？对。我在回答你的问题，可不可以先讲两句？啊，我说回答你的问题之前，先跟大家say
hello 啊。
First, I'll say hello to everyone.
然后也希望大家有点心理准备。我想大概来的时候。
I hope that you're sort of mentally prepared for this. I'm sure that if you are here, you probably know enough to be prepared.
Maybe 有人是来准备要睡觉。
You might be prepared to have a little nap.
不要有罪恶感，如果你睡着了，不要有罪恶感。
And if you do fall asleep, do not feel guilty.
因为我一直觉得戏院是最好的睡觉的地方。
You know, theater is a pretty good place to have a nap.
我通常会看电影睡着，通常是动作片。
The type of film where I fall asleep are usually the action pictures.
但是我的电影的确是很容易让你睡着。
But my films really are, it's really easy to fall asleep in them.
你稍稍有一点不集中的时候，你就跟不上来。
If you're not sort of, you know, moving with it, then you suddenly go, oh my God, I'm not there anymore.
是一个关于时间的电影。
This is a film about time.
Yeah, 但空间是少不了，一定要有空间。
But you can't have time without place.
所以我其实，我想我拍了20年，我终于发现我其实都在拍时间和空间。
I've been making films for 20 years, and I've discovered that really what I'm talking about is time and place.
即使是一个演员，也是跟时间有关系。
And the
演员。
跟演员，也是时间的概念。 And the with the actors as well, it is a thing about time.
如果我今天没有跟李康生合作20年，恐怕我不会拍这个电影。
If I had not been working together with the actor Li Kangsheng for these 20 years, then I wouldn't have made this film.
我对题材不是很有兴趣，各种议题不是特别有兴趣，社会的议题。
My films are not about society. I'm not really interested in social questions. It's not about a particular topic. It's
当然，很多人觉得这个电影是边缘人的、低下阶层的故事。
People think of this film as a film about people who live on the margins, people who live in the lower strata of society.
但是我真正的兴趣是李康生的脸。
But really, what I'm most interested in is in the face of my lead actor, Li Kangsheng.
You can see that he is now 45 years old. He from not long ago here to release his first film, which was when he was 20 years old.
When he's already 45 years old, and the first film that I made with him, he was 25. Now I'll answer your question.
这个电影基本上，好像在拍台湾或者台北的某些城市，但是你大概也看不太出这个城市的样貌，基本上没有。所以不一定是台北。对，不一定是。This
is a film. The place is a Taiwan city. It's not particularly specific, it's not necessarily Taipei.
And where
it takes place, it's all in these kind of, in these places that are like wastelands, or urban wastelands and so on. I love wastelands and ruins.
我想住在亚洲的人特别有感觉，对自己的城市的一个样貌总是非常的 argue， 说为什么那么丑。
People around Asia are often arguing about the nature of the cities they live in and the face of the cities, and you know, why is it so ugly?
但是当它变成废墟的时候，它通常都很美。
But these wastelands, these ruined places, are also very beautiful.
Yeah, 亚洲是非常多废墟的，因为它不停的盖起来，又不用它，又。 把它铲平，又盖新的，不停的做同样的事情。
And there's so many of these sort of places around all of Asia because there's this constant tearing down and building up and tearing down and building up, and it just leaves a lot of these sort of wastelands around.
通常，所以我这个电影基本上就是想拍一个废墟的电影，他有家庭，但是你看不到一个真正的家的样子。
So it's really a film about that. It's about these ruins, these places. There's a family, but it's not you know, they exist within this.
Yeah, 我不要说太多，因为马上你就会看到那些很美的废墟。
I'm not going to speak too much about that because you will see in a moment these incredibly beautiful ruins.
甚至有一个房子哈，是被烧过的。 但我没有强调它被烧过，它的确是被烧过的，那个房子应该是大概是70年代的房子，那些公寓，所以它当时的人会用壁纸，现在不用壁纸。 因为热带，当时喜欢用壁纸，比较有气派，用壁纸，所以那个壁纸的房子被烧过，跟一般的房子被烧过是不一样，加上时间，加上漏水之类，所以那些壁墙壁变得非常像一幅画，恐怕是。
There's a building in this that plays a central role in this film, and it's an old apartment building from the 1970s, which actually was destroyed in fire. Now, at that time, it was very fashionable to have wallpaper in your home. So a lot of the this is kind of a burnt out shell of a building, but there's this sort of the remains of the wallpaper, and then there's been water has gotten into the building and has turned this wallpaper into something that is, it appears like a painting, but it's a painting that no painter could paint.
我特别想讲一件事情，是我在找这些 location 的时候，我无意间的发现了一幅画，是一个壁画，用那个炭笔画了一个壁画，在一个废墟里面，没有人去的废墟里面，我发现了一个很大的画。
When I was looking for locations, I discovered this amazing mural that was made. It was made out of charcoal, and it was in this place where nobody went.
它不是一个普通的年轻人的涂鸦，不是，它是一个画家的画。
It wasn't something that some kids had just, you know, drawn on a wall. It was a proper work of an artist.
我在遇到这幅画的时候，我不知道它是谁画的。
And I didn't know who drew it, who painted it.
他改变了这个电影的结局。
And that actually changed the conclusion of this film, the ending of this film.
我想每一个人站在这个画前面都没有办法马上离开，会看很久，这就是重点。
it really did change the way this whole film is structured because when you're in front of that mural, it has this incredibly charismatic tendency. You just can't leave it, you can't tear yourself away.
我一直到在剪接台上的时候才找到这个画家，他是很有名的一个艺术家，台湾的年轻艺术家，他叫高俊宏。
And it was only much later. I said charcoal, but I think what I mean is more like pastel, like crayons or it's got color in it anyway. Anyway, at the end of the process, I finally found the artist, and he's this young artist. His name is Gao Junhong.
Gao Junhong 跟我讲他画的那幅画的来源。And
he told me why he made this painting, how it came about.
这幅画是根据英国在1894年，100多年前的一个冒险家，他要去中国，他先经过台湾，他在台湾拍了很多照片。 当时台湾的样子、地貌、原始的样子，这幅画是他拍台湾台南的一个平埔族的村庄的一个山景，这张照片目前是留在历史博物馆里面，那这幅画很有意思，我后来发现它甚至被法国人重新去变成一个版画，对，这幅画，照片。
What happened was Gao Junhong came upon a photograph which is actually in the historical museum in Taiwan, and the photograph was taken by an Englishman who was in Taiwan in 1894. And he had taken a whole lot of photographs in Taiwan, and this one was in Tainan, and he had taken this photograph of this mountain range. It's very, very beautiful. So this artist made his mural on the basis of this old photograph that was by this English person, who coincidentally, some French people, also made a wood block print of.
高俊宏很有意思，他在我的。 遇到我之后，我给他看我拍的那个镜头，有他的画的那个镜头。他后来跟我说，他非常震撼，因为他说他从来不知道晚上可以看到他的画。Later,
after I met Gao Junhong, I showed him the film, and he looked at his he saw his mural in this film, and he was really quite astonished. He was surprised because he said, I never realized you could even see this at night. Because there's a whole other sense of it.
但是我想说的是，最后我想说的是，这幅画已经不存在了，因为那个废墟已经被铲平掉了，消失了。
And this place, this mural and this place doesn't exist anymore. It's all been knocked down. So I think that's a really beautiful introduction to this film. We've been talking for, I think, exactly 15 minutes. And we're going, so what's going to happen is we'll put on the film now. And then afterwards, I'll kick off with a question or two, and then we'll open it up and we'll do this. We'll have about half an hour of Q&A. So I hope you enjoy the film, and thank you so much. That wasn't too rough on you all. So we're going to have a little Q&A. I thought I would kick it off by asking a question, because your scripts are famously short and poetic, and you don't write dialogue for the actors. So what I want to know is, what did the script say for the cabbage scene? Did it say, smother a cabbage, gouge its eyes out, eat it, and weep? This is what I want to know, is how you wrote that scene.
听懂四分之三。 剧本就是写李小康吃高丽菜。所以李康生大概从10年前就拒绝看我的剧本。看我的剧本啊，那但是我们还是会啊有时间啊聊一下，简单的说大概演什么啊，平常聊一下，就没有沟通啊，就拍的时候啊，今天要拍吃高丽菜，他就来到现场，他不知道要吃高丽菜，那他就看到有7-8个高丽菜放在旁边，我说你要把其中一个吃掉，哎。很简单的沟通，他就演，一次 ，OK， 因为你看到那个镜头，我不相信他还可以演得再好，所以我就说收工，而且也吃了很多，所以我说收工，哎，我特别开心那天，当然也很感动，因为我非常相信我的演员可以做到这么好。他真的就做到，但是我不知道他会怎么做，知道。
Basically, just said eat it. Li Kangsheng has refused to even read my scripts for the last 10 years. So basically, we just have this conversation and give him the general idea, and then he goes with it. So with this one, there were all these different cabbages, so he had to pick one. Anyway, it was one take. He just carried on, and it was amazing. And so that was it. I didn't need to ask him to do anything else, and it was really moving, actually. Okay.
现在李康生去年吧，刚刚拍完一个电影，别人的，他非常用功的读剧本。
去年
对这个电影应该会在今年出来，别人的电影他非常用功读剧本，而且那个剧本里面要讲日语，他每天都在背日语，所以我看得很生气，非常嫉妒。
你很生气。So last year Li Kangsheng was in somebody else's film, and he really worked hard at learning the script. And the script, he even had to learn to speak Japanese in the script. And he used so much effort, really put everything into it. And when I saw that, I was so angry.
I'm jealous.
Jealous. We'll open it up to questions. Do we have a roving mic? Yes, we do. Okay. So first question in the front.
Well, first of all, thank you very much for making the film. It's completely fantastic, fabulous, thank you. My question relates to the ideas and images of home and homelessness that one thinks about and watching that film, and also thinking about where you've made your films. I think one in Malaysia, mostly in Taiwan, but also in France. Is there a place or a country where you feel at home or you don't feel at home?
也在这部电影戏里有家和无家这两个概念主题然后你自己拍的戏里有马来西亚有法国有台湾然后你自己呢对家的感觉有没有一个固定的或者是定下来的家有没有一个地方是比较常见老实说我在拍这个电影之前我还是没有归属感
Before I made this film, I really didn't have a sense of where I belonged.
因为我是一个华侨，我从马来西亚来台湾，然后生活了30年在台湾。其实我心里面已经觉得台湾是我的，应该是会一直留下来的地方。
Because I am a overseas Chinese, I came from Malaysia. I've been living in Taiwan for 30 years. So Taiwan is kind of, it's the place where I choose to stay, where I will stay.
所以我其实非常喜欢在我的作品里面思考这些问题。
So I really like within my work to consider this question of home.
通常最吸引我的一些人 是那些街上的流浪汉，不管我在哪里，我都会被他们吸引。我在印度也会特别看他们，我在马来西亚我会特别看那些街上的流浪汉或者外劳，啊，我在台湾我也会特别注意街上那些，比如说举牌的人、卖房子那些，他们很多是流浪汉，那是他们唯一的工作。
Wherever I go, whether it's Malaysia or Taiwan or whatever. I'm always very drawn to the homeless, the people who live on the margins, the workers who come in from other places to work in the city. I always look at them, I study them, and very interested in them. And one of the things that I've noticed is the people in, say, Taipei who hold the signs for real estate, advertising this real estate, they very, very often are people who don't necessarily have a home themselves. And it gives me a contradictory feeling. At once, I both sympathize with them, I pity them or sympathize. At the same time, I am envious.
And
sometimes I think they lack some of the unhappiness that some of us have, mortgages, find a place to live, and so on. They just, anywhere can be home.
所以在这个电影里面，我做了一个事情，就是让那个家是一个记忆的概念，是一个真实的概念，在那个最后那个空房子里面，它不太像是真实的概念，因为它没有具体的家具。And
so in the end, in this movie, the concept of home is recognized in a recollection, a memory, which is at the end, and it's this kind of, it's not a realistic thing, there's furniture, so there's an indication that this was a home, but it's obviously not a complete home. I want to stimulate people to think afresh about the concept of home.
这两年呢，特别我跟李康生搬到一个山上，啊，一 一个郊外山上，我忽然间哪里都不想去，我觉得我有一个家。
And recently, Li Kangzheng and I moved to this place on a hill on a mountain, and suddenly I had this feeling like I don't want to go anywhere else. That's it.
后来我想说，我们花很多的时间在外面跑，外面漂泊，其实我们只是要一个山林。
We spend a lot of time roaming around, being outside, going, you know, floating. And really, what we need is that mountain.
这个山其实是我很熟悉的，因为我小时候就住在郊外，每天都看鸟，看到云，看到。可是我比较往外跑，然后最后我还是回来。
And it's a familiar feeling because when I was little, I didn't live in the city. I lived outside, and so you know, on a mountain, you wake up.Birds, there's all this stuff, and you can run away with them.
有一点啊，因为在这个家里面，我重新认识我的世界，而且我重新的发现我爱上这个世界。
Within this home, I have found my lost world and the world that I love.
我想，可能也跟我拍这电影有关系。
And it has a lot to do with making this particular film.We have a question back there.
Hello. I want to be honest with you that this is the first time I finish watching your film. So can I have a certificate? Can I have a certificate because I think that the first time I finished watching your film? Oh, well, just joking. I got two questions, just simple questions.
因为他没有在戏院里面看，他看我的盗版 DVD。
That's because he hasn't seen them in the cinemas. He's been watching the pirated versions.
Oh, this is not my question. I want to ask to a simple question. The first question is that I find out you.The way in which how you describe the detail is very different from what I perceive. What I mean is that you don't put the detail into the narratives, but you put in detail to itself, the same. So I'm wondering what do you think about the details in film? 你对于这个细节在电影里面其实是一个非常，就是说很特别的方式。你不是把细节放在叙述里面，你是把细节作为细节自身。所以你提供一个很特别的细节政治学的这种影像给我，这个对我来讲其实是一个偷球，就像你偷球李康生一样啊。所以我想要问一下，你对于这个细节在电影里面，你的电影里面他所扮演的角色跟意义。那第二个就是说，
okay,
这个
we have one question. Okay, yeah. Other people have questions too. So,
我们不要忘了啊，电影是一个影像啊，表达影像 image.
We shouldn't forget that films are the images are expressed through films.
我们一般的对电影的观念通常停留在叙述一个故事的概念。
So what we often think of as films, we're often thinking the story, we're often thinking the narration.
我自己的感觉是，这么多年下来，我很清楚电影就是一个影像的存在。
But for me, it's really about the images. It's films are about images.
所以我当然我要认真思考说那些讲故事的电影有没有什么用，有没有效果？讲故事的那些 story 对我们有没有用？
好，
我想了很久，思考了很久，我也是看电影的人，我自己有我的感受。
I see a lot of films, and I often think.What is the use of narrative? What is the purpose of story?
我举个例子啊，我们看很多战争的电影，战争的电影，可能我们都会被战争电影
a lot of war films.
撞击到，因为战争通常是很残忍的，你看完你就很想不要战争，觉得战争不好。
They're really powerful when you finish seeing them. You think, you know, we can't have war. You know, war is terrible.
但是我们一百年下来，我们还是在战争。
But you know, 100 years later, we're still
we're still in at war.
Yeah, so电影对人有什么改变，这是我们要思考。
So, you know, films can actually, do they actually change us? We should think about it.
Yeah, so我自己在发展, 希望电影回到它的本质的表达。
So what I want is
我经营的应该是 image, 不是 story.
I feel like the image and not the story is really the essence of film. So we return to that.
其实那些 image 是要激起人的感受之外，还有思考。
So these images,
激起我们的思考，对感觉，激起了感觉，但是你要思考。
So these images give us, and we have an emotional response to the images, but we also ought to be stimulated to think as well.
所以我最近有一个概念，是我常常讲的，就是说我很希望我的作品很像天上的月亮，挂在天上的月亮一样，没有一个艺术品超越月亮。
Recently, I've been had this thought, and it's I wish my films could be kind of like the moon that just sits there in the sky, because there's no film that's more beautiful than the moon.
Yeah, 因为月亮什么都不告诉你，但是你每次看它都有不同的感觉。
And
有不同的启发，我觉得很有意思。
And it doesn't tell you anything. There's no story that the moon tells you, but every single time you see it, it gives you a different inspiration or a different way of it gives you a different spark. It gives you a different way of thinking.
其实这个月亮也是代表大自然，一朵花，一朵。所以我觉得我们
And of course that represents nature as a whole. Flowers.
我不太看大自然，宁愿看天上天，我的电影偏偏遇到云也不要看天上的云，你知道吧？所以我这次是一个问题，尤其现在有手机之后，所以我很希望我的电影不要卖给飞机，不要卖给那些网络，我希望说就是用一种独特的方式，观看的方式被看到，被使用的，所以，但是我这种电影很难在戏院生存，所以我自己去开发一个美术馆的概念，电影进美术馆。So,
I like people to, I don't like the idea of, I hope my films are sold onto airplanes for viewing on airplanes. I hope that, you know, I don't want them to be watched on the internet. I even have trouble with the idea of theaters. So recently I've come up with this new thing, which is to work with art galleries.
I just wonder, you made Li Kangsheng recite Manjiang Hong, and what was the reason of it? There seem to be so many possibilities, but what did you want to say when he recited Manjiang Hong?
So, and I'll just make a note in case people don't know, the poem Manjiang Hong is what this lady was talking about, and it's a Song Dynasty poem by a guy called Yue Fei, who was a famous patriot.
因为李康生会唱满江红，真的。Because
Li Kangsheng will sing. I've just done that thing. Because Li Kangsheng can sing it. That's why.
对，我觉得，但是我必须要说，那些站在那边卖房子的人，他们非常辛苦，有一种辛苦是，他什么也不能做的辛苦。 他也不能听Walkman， 他那些年龄的人都没有这些东西，他就是站着，他不能把他的东西放在地上，因为那是犯法的，会被环保局抓。他一样拿着，他上厕所，他要找地方去放，搜一下藏起来。所以，你想想看，一个人站8小时，站着什么都不做，只是站着，是很难熬的。所以我在观察他们的时候，我花一点时间观察他们，我就看到很多人会自己讲话。 会唱歌或者会自言自语，自然的，好，然后我当然也会故意跑过去问说，哎，你刚才说什么？那有个人说我在念经，念心经，你知道吗？哈，等等，然后我就，好。
So I look at these guys who stand by the road holding these signs, and the thing is about this work is that they
They're not allowed to do anything else, so they can't listen to, you know, music. They can't even put something down on the ground. They can't rest their sign. They stand there for 8 hours. If they have to go and relieve themselves, they have to take the sign with them. It's absolutely grueling, and so as a result, they I've discovered that they often, well, they're not talking to themselves or singing, and so I've gone up to them sometimes and gone, what are you singing, what are you saying? And some of them are reciting the sutras.
我想起李康生会唱《满江红》，是在平常的生活里面，他是会唱《满江红》，因为那个年代的小孩子都会背《满江红》，在学校里面，所以我当然要想说，李康生要干嘛？唱《满江红》，《满江红》当然就会，不是随便选的，也是很认真的想一想，他对于这个电影的重要性，他其实讲了一种感受。 我想每个时代的很多人的感受都很像，到底我的付出得到什么回报，也许是报国上战场，也许是争取一个职位，通通都。所以我觉得这个电影是有点像老子的思想，就是在问我们为什么活着，其实是有一点像老子，天地不仁呐，以万物为刍狗，每一个人都是。
First of all, Li Kangsheng, I knew that he could recite this poem, that he could sing this poem, so obviously that was a consideration. Because the generation to which he belongs, everybody learned that poem in school, so everybody can recite that poem. But it wasn't just a random choice, because at the same time, what is in this poem is very expressive of a kind of a sentiment that I was thinking about. The poem, the recitation of this poem, this movie also, the way I've made this film also has a connection to the thoughts of Lao Zi, the Taoist philosopher, and Tian Di Buren. Who's impossible to translate? Anybody going to try? Tendi Buren.
Tendi Buren 应该是说，这个世界是不仁慈的，上天是不仁慈的。上天。The
nature itself is no mercy.
Yeah, there's no mercy in the world.
Yes.
Yeah. Like people just they exist and there's no. There's no mercy towards them. I think we've got time for one more. And yeah, back there, last.
Correct.
You talked about images, and obviously I see the importance of the images, but I was very struck by the importance of sound in this film. And I want to ask you, and you're giving us an aesthetic experience that's visual but also auditory, right? And I want to ask you how much you considered sound when you were lining up those languid, long shots that you use. How much was that a part of your calculation in deciding on the shots?
然后呢，他说，这个声音很重要的，然后呢，你在安排那些比较那些长的那些镜头，尤其是长的镜头里，你先考虑多少？考虑那个场地的声音，这个是不是你考？我的声音基本上每个电影声音都是用一些还原的概念，还原回来。我录到什么就还原回来。你知道为什么？还原就。 Quiet return.
Yeah.
So basically, my idea is that with all my films is that I return the sound to you.
但是那些声音有时候会造成一种困扰。And
it's a kind of a disturbance.
所以
困扰。 it's kind of an annoyance as well.
可能有些人觉得那个声音不重要，不必要，好像跟内容没有关系。
And some people might think that the particular sounds aren't that important, so, you know, why not? But I think they're very important.
所以我每次进studio做声音的时候，我就必须要跟我的技术人员做很多的沟通，因为他们的习惯，他们是工业概念，他们觉得电影就应该要用有用的东西，好，可是我喜欢用无用的东西。
And so each time I work with the post-production crew, I have to communicate with them really clearly because the way that they work normally in this industry is to get rid of what is unnecessary. And I actually like most what is unnecessary.
Yeah.
And it seems to happen all the time. I go into the post-production studio, and they've already gotten rid of all this stuff, and I'm like, no, bring it back.
Yeah, 这样子会重新提醒我当时我在拍的那个空间到底在哪里。
And it feels like it reminds me of exactly where this space was.
Yeah, 比如说小朋友经过一个树林。 我们其实认真听，有一个小学的声音，很多小朋友在玩声远远的，其实那是在一个小学附近的废墟里面。你以为在树林，其实它是在城市里面，所以这个电影永远在城市里面，它并没有脱离城市。那城市很奇怪，出现了很多树林。
And this the scene where the kids come out of from behind that tree. It seems like they're in the middle of some deep forest or jungle, but in fact, it's in the middle of the city. It's just one of these kind of waste areas. And what's really important in the sound in that one is that in the distance, very, very softly, if you listen, you can hear the sounds of a primary school. You can hear kids. And so they seem to be completely separated from the city and everything that's going on there, but it's really, really close.
根据他讲到有用没有用这个事情，我也很想说，我很喜欢没有用的时间。电影里面时间都要有用，但是我喜欢没有用的时间。比如说那两个人站了很久，是完全没有用的，有时候是没有意义的。可是我喜欢那个没有意义。I
really do like the things that are not only useless, but also possibly meaningless. So sometimes I choose those sort of things. So the two people standing there with the signs for that long, it really doesn't necessarily, it's not necessarily something that has use or particular meaning, the extent of that. Because most of life goes past without use or meaning.
可是话说回来，很多观众会argue我说，为什么这么长？我觉得只有一种，只有一个回答是最正确的，就是说这是我的电影。And
sometimes, you know, the audience or people who've seen this movie, they'll be like, why is it so long? You know, they'll have an argument about this with me, and I'll say, why? Because it's my movie.